The red ribbon is actually the very first ribbon of remembrance. You know, it's the one that started all of the other ribbons, like the pink ribbon for breast cancer and the yellow ribbon for cancer and all these other different ribbons and bracelets. You know, the red ribbon did start this whole ribbon of remembrance thing. So, but we also want you to act aware. Which was actually last year's main theme was act aware. Be aware. Be aware of people you know that are living with this disease and their situations. Be aware of all the methods of actual transmission of HIV and you know, just be aware of the stuff. Be aware that this disease has not gone away. It is still killing people. And it's not the actual disease that kills people. It's the opportunistic infections we get when you bring the malaria home. Colds. During the highest points of cold and flu season, MainelyButch will not even go to the grocery store. Okay? I will ask my mother or my sister or somebody to pick me things up at the grocery store. I'll absolutely shun public places when there is serious outbreaks of colds and flus. And even though I do get pneumonia shots, I get the mega flu shot, okay? Flu shot on top of the regular number 7 flu shot I got. So act aware, please, you know? Protect yourself, protect others, protect those you love. And if you don't have all the facts on HIV, act like you know. Get online, Google it. You know, Google WHO, Google World AIDS Day 2012. You know, I mean, Google is just, you can Google fucking anything. Try Googling your own name. That's a scary fucking proposition, guys. Because I know you've done it. If you ever Googled your own name, hit the like button. I want to know how many of you that watch this video have Googled your own name. And if you don't want to Google it, contact me. I'll answer your questions to the best of my ability. And if I don't have the answers to your questions, or if I have an answer but I want you to read more, I will give you the correct links to go to read or learn. You know, I think almost everybody in the world at this particular point in time has got to know somebody living with HIV, whether you know it or not, okay? Because you got to remember that pretty much most of the people that are infected don't even know. So they don't even know when they're giving it to you. So be careful. You know, you're safer with somebody who knows they have HIV than you are with somebody who doesn't know, because the person who knows how to protect you. And the person who knows how to protect themselves. And I don't care how good you think you are at telling that somebody has it. You can't tell that a person has HIV. You just can't, okay? I mean, I'm sorry, but I am healthy as a horse. You would never tell by meeting me unless I told you directly to your face that I live with this fucking monster. So, well, unless you see the poison sign I have tattooed on my back. And staying healthy. If you have HIV, if you have a family member that has HIV, a partner, anybody that you come in contact with on a regular basis, if you're around somebody who's immune compromised, it's just common sense that you make sure that you don't carry in a whole bunch of germs with you, because they can be very dangerous if they're exchanged to the person with the compromised immune system. That goes not only for just HIV, but other immune compromising diseases like rheumatoid arthritis and lupus and several other different autoimmune diseases. You know, those people are at a higher risk to catch the kind of stuff that, you know, you can blow off in 2 days. Takes me 2 motherfucking weeks. The specific ways of catching HIV, obviously, I'm not going to go into in this video. I'm not even going to talk about. Be aware. Be aware, okay? Get the facts. Live the facts. Know the facts. You're not going to get it by kissing or touching or, you know, there's some very specific blood exchange and bodily fluid exchange information in HIV 101. If I will put HIV 101 in the description box below, and you can check it out. If so, if you got a question, If you have a comment, if you have something you want to say to me, or you want to ask a question, I feel no question about HIV is a stupid question. So, you can private message me, you can leave them down in the comments. If you want me to do more in video, you can leave it in the comments and I will do more video about it. I do have some older videos about HIV, and I have openly talked about this on my channel since I opened my channel almost 4 years ago. So. It's not always just like a roll of the dice, you can get infected the first time. It can happen in a one-time encounter and or incident or sharing of one time of a needle. It can happen. It can happen. I'm here to tell you. That's where it goes. Anyway, I hope you have an awesome fucking week. Make sure that you hit the like button. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you think. Subscribe if you're not a subscriber on my channel. And come back for more because I got some good shit coming up. Talk to you later. Peace.